Are you using your brain? Do you not want to be proactive with your health? Think of it. If you're willing to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars in steroids, why are you willing to spend hundreds of dollars on ensuring that you're healthy? Coach Greg, and today I'm going to be going over Ryan Akram's 20-week cycle. Derek, he did a review of him. I'm going to do a separate review different than Derek. I'm going to give you my own personal opinion on his cycle. Obviously, it's going to be different from Derek. So if you haven't checked out Derek's, watch my video, compare what I said to what he said. Hopefully you can learn something. Let's see if we have the same thoughts, different thoughts, whatever. So let's get started and let's get checked. Today's video is sponsored by Let's Get Checked. If you want to know if you're healthy, unhealthy, if you have high, low testosterone levels, whether your cholesterol is out of whack, you can get Let's Get Checked to try. Use code GREG30 to get 30% off. It's a good deal. So Let's Get Checked. It's the first company I partnered with. Give it a try.
I haven't taken anything this entire year. So you know my receptors are fresh, you know my body's rested, and I am ready to go.
So he hasn't taken anything for an entire year, and obviously that means he's going to respond very well to what he's taking. If you're always cycling PDs and you don't take very much time off, what you are taking is not going to have as large of an impact. So the more often you do a cycle, the higher the dose has to be to get any result out of it. Let's face it, if your first cycle was 500 milligrams a test and 5 years later you're doing 5,000 milligrams, if you only do 500 milligrams, you're not going to gain anything because your body is used to higher and higher doses. But do remember the law of diminished returns, it always applies. If you gain 10 pounds of muscle on 500 milligrams, you're not going to gain 100 pounds of muscle on 5,000 milligrams. And if you go past a certain threshold, you're certainly going to put your body in jeopardy. Health risks get amplified. You might feel like garbage. So you have to always decide, is what I'm doing actually worth it? Before I get into this, let me preface by saying I am not a freaking doctor. I don't know anything about anything. I hardly even know how to spell my name. So if you watch this video and take information from me, well, you're a freaking idiot. You're a moron. Go see your actual doctor. I am not a doctor. This is just purely for entertainment. You like listening to me to scream and shout? That's what I'm going to try to do here.
First and foremost, the king, the OG test Cypionate. I'm going to be doing that from week 1 to week 20.
A good cycle almost always has testosterone as the base of the cycle, and he's chosen to use test Cypionate, essentially exactly the same as test Enanthate. Has approximately a 5-day half-life, so you need to inject it usually 2 or 3 times a week to get ideal stable blood levels. He's using 600 milligrams, which would be a lot for a beginner, but it's not his first rodeo. He's done this before, so 600 seems perfectly reasonable. When I've done cycles in the past, I've used as much as 700 milligrams, so this to me seems perfectly reasonable.
All in all, this will be a 20-week cycle. Now, keep in mind, guys, you know, this is not a beginner cycle. It's not stupid crazy.
But 20 weeks? That is a long time. That is a long cycle. I would never suggest you do something that long. Of course you can, but do you really want to do a cycle for 20 weeks? What's going to happen is for the first 8 to 12 weeks, he's going to make fantastic progress. But then, body's going to get used to it. So really, what I would prefer to see is he would use a lower dose of testosterone at the start and then increase the dose as the cycle goes on. The first 8 weeks, he's probably going to grow a lot on half as much testosterone, but the final 8 weeks, not going to grow very much, even though he's using 600 milligrams.
Starting at week 4 through week 15, I'm going to be doing NPP, 360 milligrams per week, 120 milligrams on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
He's adding the NPP at 4 weeks because he says he's waiting for the test to get into his system. It's going to be in his system in about 3 days. There's no reason to wait 4 weeks. However, I wouldn't even add it at week 4. The test alone, just testosterone, for the first 8 weeks would be more than enough. He has not done anything for a year. 600 milligrams of test only, he's gonna get amazing results. Trust me, mind-blowing results on just testosterone. So adding in NPP at 4 weeks, it's overkill. Also, what are my thoughts of NPP? Well, if you're going to be using NPP for that long, why not just inject actual DECA, the longer estered form? That way you won't have to inject it as often. Many people think NPP is superior to longer acting DECA. I don't believe that to be the case. If you're doing a long ester testosterone, why not couple that with a long ester for DECA? That way you could do the injections on the same day, twice a week. NPP, you're literally going to have to inject that every 2 days. He's doing 3 injections a week. What that means is some of the injections are going to be every 2 days, but one of them is going to be every 3 days. Do you get that? There's 7 days in a week. That's an odd number. 6 days, that's an even number. Every other day injections would mean he has to inject it every 6 days, 3 times. But there's 7 days in a week. So when designing a cycle, it's not always easy to just say, do this every week. Think of it as, do this every other day, do this every 10 days. It don't have to be designed based on the week. So if using NPP, may as well just use Test Probe. You can do those at the same time. Another disadvantage of using faster esters is that you have to inject it more frequently. Every time you inject, you're actually stabbing yourself. You're putting a hole in your body. That's dangerous because harmful bacteria can come into the skin and get infected. So every time you pin yourself, you do risk infection. Longer esters, they're stronger. NPP usually dosed at 100 milligrams per mil, while DECA usually 300 milligrams. So less injection volume, done less frequently, more likely to not get an infection.
And to be frank with you guys, I should really get back in the gym for a little bit before I do a cycle, but you know, I'm kind of throwing caution to the wind.
So he's taken time off from the gym, been injured, and right away he's throwing it in with a cycle. Also not really the best idea because he would actually have the ability to get gains without the PDs. Newbie gains. He's already had muscle in the past, and if you train natural, you can actually build muscle. So why not maximize your natural potential before adding the cycle back in? But hey, that's his decision. It's his decision to make. There's nothing physically wrong with doing that.
At week 5 and week 10, I will be getting some light blood work done to see where my estrogen's at, to see where my prolactin's at because of the MPP, and also see where my SHBG is at.
And yes, it is a good idea to get your blood work done before, during, and after cycle just to see what's going on. But listen, you gotta expect something wrong is going to be going on if you do it during the cycle. A lot of times people send me their blood work. They're like, yeah, my estrogen is really high. Of course it's high. You're blasting testosterone, test converting to estrogen. Of course, if you have 3,000 nanograms per deciliter testosterone, obviously your estrogen is going to be higher than normal. That is normal. So just because you get your blood work done and it shows you certain things while on cycle, doesn't actually mean that you're going to know what to do. The point of getting blood work during the cycle is to see, are you handling it okay? Or are you being a complete moron and you need to get off the cycle early? This is the danger and this is what you want to do. When you're on cycle, you want to see, what is my cholesterol? What's my blood pressure? Is my HDL-LDL ratio way out of whack? Is it 20 to 1, 30 to 1? Because if it is, this not good. What are my creatinine levels? How are your kidneys doing? These are the things you need to find out. It's not just about, do I have high estrogen levels or prolactin? Those are minor consequences in comparison to if you're going to have a heart attack or a kidney failure. And what about your liver? Is your AST and ASL way out of whack, 5 times the normal range? Or is it that's a little bit elevated? Because frankly, if you are blasting a cycle, expect something to be wrong. Because frankly, if you're blasting doing a cycle, something's going to be wrong. I've never seen anyone do a cycle and everything come back perfect. Unless you're only on HRT, then you could be. But if you're blasting using 10 times normal doses, super physiological doses, expect to have some problems. The thing is, get your blood work done and see. Are these problems that bad? Are they a little bit? Is it worth it? That's up for you to decide. Not for me, for you.
If you're looking for an easy and a cost-effective way to check your testosterone, your estrogen, your prolactin, and your SHBG, then my friends over at Let's Get Checked can help.
And look at that, he's sponsored by the same company as Coach Greg. Let'sGetChecked.com. We have something in common. Use code GREG30 and you get 30% off at letsgetchecked.com.
On week 4 through week 7, I'm going to have Superdraw in there at 20 milligrams per day.
At week 4, he's just adding in NPP. You don't need to add in NPP and Superdraw that early. Superdraw is super liver toxic. It feels great, it's good, it's gonna make you strong, but you don't need it this early. If he had just used testosterone and no NPP and said, I'm going to add in Superdraw at weeks 4 to 8, I could see doing that. And 20 milligrams a day, that's not so crazy. I've seen people doing 60 milligrams. I took 100 by accident once. Don't tell anyone. Measured it wrong. Did the 0.1 thing and a decimal. And so I took 100 milligrams by accident instead of 0.1. Had a freaking good workout that day, trust me. But not recommending anyone abuses it and takes high doses like that. Typically, 10 to 30 milligrams a day maximum is all you should take in divided doses.
Week 8 through 11, I'm gonna take a break and not take any orals. Take a break, give my body a break, give my liver a break.
Because of the strain on the liver, he's gonna take a break weeks 8 through 11 from the Superdraw. But why not just wait later? Think of it, you're going to be using Superdraw for 4 weeks and then you stop. So you're gonna feel like Superman for 4 weeks and then you're gonna take it away. So you're gonna be actually in the first 8 weeks doing a very strong cycle and then it's tapering down to a weaker cycle halfway through. Doesn't make sense. At first, everything is going to work, but as you go, you then need stronger supplements to keep adding more muscle. So I don't like this idea, adding in Superdraw so early week 4 and then stopping it for later.
At week 12 through week 15, I'm gonna throw Halo in there, 20 milligrams per day, 10 milligrams in the morning, pre-workout for that aggression and intensity.
And then he's adding in 20 milligrams of Halo. That is super toxic to the liver. He's not a bodybuilder. He's not competing in a powerlifting competition. This is not something you should take at all. Why does he need the increased aggression? And why is he choosing Halo? I 100% do not advise him to do this or you. Of course, it's his body, but if I was his coach, which I'm not, wouldn't do it. Especially this early in the cycle. If his goal was to maximize his strength, well, maybe you could add that at the end. Maybe week 17, 18, 19, 20 at the end to peak out your strength. But why midway through the cycle do you need increased aggression? You should be able to train plenty hard without it. After all, you're on DECA and test. Why do you need Halo for increased aggression?
I'm actually a huge fan of doing this, where you have two orals in a cycle, but you don't stack them. You take one, and then you take 3 or 4 weeks off to give your body a break.
And I am not a big fan of that. I'm more a fan of taking the orals the second half of the cycle and building up in dose or taking it throughout the cycle in such a low dose that it's not harmful to the liver. For example, 10 milligrams of Anavar a day for 16 weeks, body can handle that. I'm not a doctor. I'm not telling you to take 10 milligrams of Anavar. I'm just saying body probably can handle that. Same as body can probably drink 1 or 2 beer a day for 16 weeks and probably not die.
I'm also going to be going in and giving blood. That way I get my red blood cell count down, get my hematocrit down, my hemoglobin, all that stuff since I am on TRT.
So technically he's not off everything. He's on HRT and I never heard what dose he's on. And typically most people telling you they're on HRT, especially guys who are jacked, it's not actually HRT doses. It's usually a lot higher. So that might be why he's taking 600 milligrams of test plus the NPP. If he was actually 100% off everything, 600 tests would be crazy mind-blowing. But maybe his HRT, maybe it's 250 milligrams. Mine's 120. If I took 600, wow, I would notice it in a heartbeat. But if he's at 250, 600, it's not really that much more. You still notice it. but not nearly as much as 120.
On week 4 through week 15, I'm gonna throw in 20 milligrams of RAD 140.
And on top of this, he's going to be taking RAD 140, which is a SERM. And what do I think of this? It's a bit much. He's already adding in the Superdrol and the Halo and RAD 140. I've seen people's blood work. I've seen it. It's not 100% safe. It's not liver friendly. You can't just think, oh, I'm gonna take these SARMs, it's completely safe. He's saying it can help the prostate. Well, maybe, maybe, but it can hurt the liver. Can hurt your cholesterol.
I am also going to be having Stenobolic in there. So what I'm gonna be doing is taking 30 milligrams all at once in the morning with a big meal, something that's gonna be high in fat.
And I 100% disagree with taking 30 milligrams of Stenobolic, which is SR9009. It doesn't really have a lot of absorption ability. So in my mind, way better to split this dose out to at least 3 times a day. Rather than taking 30 milligrams all at once, take 10 milligrams 3 times daily, or better yet, 5 milligrams 6 times daily. That's just my personal opinion, not 100% sure if that's going to help, but its bioavailability, it's not the greatest. So I'm not a fan of this idea of taking 30 milligrams all at once, rather see it spread out throughout the day. This is supposed to help with burning fat, and why take it all at once when you can spread it out and get the benefits throughout the entirety of the day?
I am also going to be throwing in there 1,500 milligrams of Tutka per day. I wish we could have it in Shield, but call it what it is a very expensive compound.
And he has a product called Shield, which he's helping for liver support and so on, but it doesn't have Tutka in it because he says it costs too much. So, spend the money on the Tutka, which you want, and sell it. He literally doesn't put in Tutka into his Shield because it costs too much. If you want the best possible product, you gotta pay the top dollar. I made a liver support product. I sure as heck put Tutka in it, even though it costs more than every other ingredient. It's in there because you need it. If you're blasting PDs, don't you want to do what it takes to be healthy? Are you using your brain? Do you not want to be proactive with your health? Think of it. If you're willing to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars in steroids, why are you willing to spend hundreds of dollars on ensuring that you're healthy? And no, it's not going to make you 100% healthy, but if it does work a little bit, it's worth it. Is your life not worth it? So Shield, it's good, but it doesn't have Tutka, so you're going to need to have both. So you can get Shield, but be sure to get Tutka as well because, well, it's a product that works and it should be in there, but it was too expensive, so he didn't add it in there because profit margins, and that's more important than helping you.
I will have Aromasin on hand. And of course, as you guys know, you only take AIs such as Remedex and Aromasin as needed.
And as far as an AI is concerned, at 600 milligrams, it's almost certain that his estrogen is going to be very, very highly elevated. But if you've experienced testosterone before, you would know if you're prone to getting gyno. No one wants gyno. Here's what I would do. I would take Arimidex or Aromasin along with the 600 milligrams of test because you're probably going to need it. Is it 100% guaranteed that you will need it? No, but you probably will. And guess what? I know you don't want gyno. I know you don't. And it's not that you have to take an aromatase inhibitor, but do you want to risk getting the gyno? Probably not. So take a little bit, Arimidex, maybe 0.5 milligram, 2-3 times a week. Unless you've done a cycle before, you don't know. But hey, you're going to be safe, 0.5 milligram. Not that it's safe to take an Arimidex, not that it's safe to do anything I'm saying, but I'm saying what I would do, and what I would do is add in 0.5 milligram of Arimidex probably 2 or 3 times a week.
Because of the MPP, the short estradiol, you can run into some prolactin issues, but I'm going to go ahead and take P5P. That is just an over-the-counter supplement.
And at the dose of MPP he's on, I really don't think he's going to need cabergoline or anything for prolactin. It's not a high dose. I think he's good to go without it. If you're going on crazy high doses, you probably need it, but you shouldn't be on crazy high doses in the first place. So rather than that, what he could be doing, which is what I'd want to do, is lower the testosterone dose and add something like Masterone or Primo, something that doesn't convert to estrogen. That way, not as likely to get Gino. We don't want Gino, so why not add that? He has the money, he can afford it. It's not like he can't get it. He has all he needs and what he wants. So why not add those products? And by adding in Primo or Masteron, he probably wouldn't need as much Deca. And then at a lower dose of Deca, probably no issues with prolactin. So it's a win-win-win situation. Doesn't need to worry about as much. Gonna have more dry gains, less bloated, and look better and have less need for aromatase inhibitors or CABR.
If P5P doesn't take care of it, I will toss in CABR at a half a milligram Monday and Thursday.
And I'd say probably 250 micrograms rather than 500 twice a week. I think half of that twice a week would be plenty, especially that he's not sure if he needs it. And if you're not sure if you need it and you end up needing it, better to start on a lower dose. Why not 250 micrograms instead of 500 twice a week, 250 twice a week. And then if you still have problems, then go to the 500. So use the lowest dose that makes you happy. That's the advice I give you all the time. The lowest dose that works. So don't go for more when less is going to be enough.
But I will be tossing injectable L-carnitine in there at 600 milligrams per day.
Do you really want to pin yourself every single day with L-carnitine? When you could just get my friggin' cookbook, eat delicious low-calorie meals that make you full satisfied, it's gonna help you get leaner. L-carnitine, yeah, it can work, but do you really want to have to inject yourself every single day?
Do not dismiss the stuff that's gonna keep you healthy. It doesn't matter how jacked you are, it doesn't matter how shredded you are. If you're dead, it doesn't matter.
And it's a good point. Doesn't matter how friggin'.
It doesn't matter!
The Rock, he also knows this. It doesn't matter how jacked you are if you're dead. So please, be cautious with your health. Let'sgetchecked.com. Get your blood work done. Are you in fact healthy or are you not healthy? If you're not, don't do this stuff. And even if you are healthy, don't do this stuff. Don't! Unless you're a moron like me, I've done this stuff in the past for 10 years. Now I'm just on HRT, 120 milligrams a week. Y'all know that. Half of you don't believe me. Whatever.
And last but not least, one of the most important things is your nutrition, your training, your cardio.
Exactly. Don't forget to do your cardio. You're willing to do what it takes to get the muscle you want. You need to be willing to do what it takes to live long enough to enjoy it. And trust me, if you do cardio, you're likely to live a longer, healthier life. And especially if you're abusing PDs, don't you need to do every single thing in your power to negate the harmful effects of what you're doing on the cycle? I think so. Look what I'm doing. I'm an IPV pro bodybuilder racing bicycles for my heart, the most important freaking muscle, more important than the chesticles, the delts, biceps, more important than everything. Don't neglect your heart. 150 minutes of cardio a week. And of course, don't bulk up and force feed, eat Wendy's thinking all that extra food's gonna build more muscle. Get the freaking cookbook, eat healthy, main gain, stay at a healthy body fat percentage that's healthy for you, and build muscle from there. Hopefully you learned something from this video. Ending it here. GregDucette.com for coaching. GregDucette IP Pro. Watch one of the bloops. Don't forget to buy the freaking cookbook, training book. You can hire me and my coaching team to give you coaching plans. Go and watch Derek's video after this. See, are we the same, different? What does he recommend? And until next time, I'm out.